As you can see, the underside of my rear fender has a lot of surface rust and is very pitted. To remove this rust, I have a few options. I could remove it mechanically using a wire brush or a sandblaster, however, I would run into a few problems. First problem, there's a few tight corners where it would be really hard for me to reach all the rust. Two, I might heat the metal to a point where it warps. And three, I might thin down the metal too much. I could also remove the rust chemically. However, that also has a few problems. The first problem is that it's not environmentally friendly to dispose of the wastes. The second problem is that it's fairly costly. If I were to use the best solution of chemical removal, it would have to be half vinegar, half water. And even for me to fit this fender in that solution, I would need 375 gallons. And that would cost me about $500. And also, even that, with removing it, I would kill a lot of fish here in Teddyland. And no teddy bear wants to go without fish for dinner. So let me ask you, what would Chris Hemsworth do?
Showing!
Chris Hemsworth would use electrolysis. For electrolysis, you're going to need a few key ingredients. First is obviously your rusty piece of metal. Second, a car battery charger. Third, your water tank. Fourth, a sacrificial piece of metal. And this piece of metal needs to be cast iron or steel. No stainless steel, otherwise you'll introduce chromium to your water tank. And hexavalent chromium is a terrible way to get cancer. Fifth, you're going to need a form of electrolyte to make the water more conductive. Normal table salt will do, as well as baking soda or sodium bicarbonate. However, the best to use is sodium carbonate or normal washing soda. You're going to need about a tablespoon per gallon, and for my 375-gallon tank, I needed about 4 boxes. Before I start, I'm going to use this soap and water to wash any excess oil off the part. Now I'm going to submerge it in the tank. I'm going to put my sacrificial anode in to where it has line of sight to all the most rusty areas of my part and to where it can't touch the part. For your electrical connection, you don't want to use anything but steel or cast iron because any other metal will introduce ions to the solution that will cause problems. So I am using a steel coat hanger instead of a copper wire to connect my piece. I've hooked my positive lead from my car battery charger to my sacrificial anode, then my negative to my car part. Once the electricity starts flowing through this, it's going to create two different reactions. The first reaction is when the water molecules, hydrogen and oxygen, are going to be breaking apart. The hydrogen is going to be bubbling off of the cathode, then the oxygen is going to be bubbling off of the anode. Now, children, don't do this in your basement, because the hydrogen will also go into the air, and hydrogen is a very flammable gas. And it is a terrible way to blow off all your limbs. Now, the second reaction is the most important and the reason we are doing this.
This rust, or ferric oxide, or Fe2O3, is an unstable compound, and so once the electricity starts flowing through this, it will become magnetite, or Fe3O4, and become a stable compound.
If you look really carefully along the edge, you can see the bubbling of the hydrogen coming off the cathode. You can also see the oxygen coming off the anode.
hours, and as you can see, the water's nice and foggy with pieces and paint and rust that have flaked off. And the corner of the piece itself has some black where the magnetite has replaced the rust and where the rust is falling off. Once I got the fender cleaned up, I could still see a tiny bit of rust in the deep pits, so I put it back in to cook overnight.
Here's a before and after of a piece that I have finished and then a piece that I haven't. These two rear fenders were in roughly the same condition before I started, so you can see that the electrolysis worked really well. I had to use an older car battery charger because the newer one wouldn't let me run any amps through it unless there was an actual battery connected to it. I run my car battery charger at 100 amps, and realistically, it was nearly done at 5.5 hours, so if I left it in for 7 hours, it most likely would have been completely finished. So if you ran yours for 10 amps, it would be done in about 2 days. See you next time, kids, on Hannah's Bug. As always, this show is filmed in front of a live studio audience.
That tasted weird.